Hi, in this video series we shall be creating a fictitious map of schools with Django, GeoDjango, Docker, Nginx, React, and Lift.js. So let's start off by creating our working directory. So you can say make dir, we got, let's call this Django schools map. Then we can cd into Django schools map. Then create a project source directory where all our source code shall live. So you can say make directory schools-src, then you can cd into that directory. Then ensure you have Python installed. I have Python version 3.9. We are going to create a virtual environment. Python virtual environments help in creating isolated environments for Python projects. So in a terminal we can say Python 3.9-m, use the virtual environment package. Our environment is going to be called env. Then once it's created, we are going to activate the virtual environment with source env /bin/activate. With our virtual environment created, we now install Django, Django REST framework, Django REST framework JS. The versions to install can be found in the respective documentation or in the Python package index. So back in the terminal, we can say pip install Django. Let's say we want Django 3.1.5, then Django REST framework version 3.12.2. Then you can say Django REST framework -js. I want version 0.17. Then Django leaflet, we want version 0.27.1. Nice, with our packages installed, let's upgrade the version of pip as per the command. Say pip install --upgrade pip. Good, then we can confirm our installations with pip freeze. Let's just confirm that. Good. Then let's create a requirements.txt file to specify the package versions required in our application. So we can say pip freeze --requirements.txt. Then now that Django is installed, we can create a Django project with the Django admin.py management command. So you can say Django admin.py start project, and we're going to call this schools_api, create it in the current directory with a dot. Like that. Then we're going to create a schools app in our source directory. So you can say python 3 manage.py, start app. We're going to call this schools. With our project and our app created, we can launch our code editor. Since I'm using VS Code, I can just use my alias code dot. With that out of the way, we can add our schools app, Django REST framework, Django REST framework JS, leaflet, and Django contribute JS as part of our installed applications. So go back to settings.py file here. Under the sections for installed apps, we can add this. We can add our, so we can add django.contrib.js. Then we're going to add our schools app. Then you're going to add leaflet. Then you're going to add, Then you're going to add REST framework. Then you're going to add REST_framework_JS, like that. We shall display our maps in the admin using leaflet instead of the default open layers, but we have to provide some configuration for that. So back in this same settings.py file, we can scroll to the bottom. So first, let me change my time zone. Let me say I'm in Africa, currently in Kigali. Then here we can say leaflet config. It's going to be a dictionary. So we can say we're going to create a default center, a default zoom, maximum zoom, mean zoom, scale, and attribution. So we can say our default center is going to be, since I'm in Kigali, I'll get the latitude and longitude of Kigali. It's -1.94. This is where I want my center to be. And 29.87. Then my default zoom, I want it to be 8. I want to have a default zoom of 8. Then I want to have a maximum zoom of 10. Sorry, maximum zoom of 20. Then I want to have both scales in miles and in kilometers in my map. So you can just add that. Then I want to have an attribution prefix. So just some text to be displayed on my map canvas. So you can customize this to whatever. So I can just say my attribution prefix is going to be API imperfect schools map. Then you save this file. So in the schools app models.py file, we shall create our school models. So here we shall create our school model. So we have some imports to make. So this time we are going to say from django.contrib. Whoa. django.contrib.gis.db import models. Then we are going to say from django.utils.translation import get text underscore lazy as underscore. This is to help with our translation. Then we're going to create a tuple of choices. So remember, when in our choices field, the first element in each tuple is the actual value to be set on the model, and the second element is the human readable name. So we're going to have a tuple for our provinces, the school, and the school levels. So we can say province choices is going to be a tuple. So in Rwanda we have 5 provinces. We have 4 provinces plus Kigali City. So you can just copy that, adding this to the tuple. Then the school levels, we're going to have another one for the school levels. So you can say level choices is going to be, so we can have the tuple again. So feel free to change this data to what suits your needs. This is just for demonstration purposes. So we can have pre-nursery in our choices, nursery, primary, general, TVET, general tertiary, and adult tertiary. Then we are going to create our school model. So class is a school model, subclasses, models.model. Then we're going to have some fields. So we're going to have a name field, the name of the school, which is models.character field. Then we're going to have some helper text. You can see this is going to be the school name. Then you can see the maximum length is going to be 100 and it's going to be unique. Unique is true. Then we're going to have a province. So the province is going to be models.character field. Then it's going to be, here we can see this is a school province. Then you're going to have a maximum length of 30. Then we can see for the choices is going to be the province choices tuple up above. So you can see province choices. Then we're going to have another field for district. We can get models.character field, then underscore. You can see this is going to be a school district. School district. Then we can say maximum length is going to be 50. Then we're going to have the next field for the levels. So let me just copy the province field. So this is going to be level, and this is going to be the school level. The maximum length is going to be 30. The choices this time is going to be the level choices. Then we're going to have another field for the male and female, which are just going to be integer fields. So you can just say male is going to the integer field, male students, default is 0. Then we are going to have another field for the female, it's an integer field again. Then we're going to have another field for electricity availability, so we can just add that. It's going to be a boolean field and the default is going to be false. Then we're going to have a school code, so school code is going to be an integer field. Then we are going to have a location field. So location field is going to be a point field with an SRID, a special reference identifier of 4326. Then we're going to have created at and updated at fields, which are both basically date time fields. So we can just get this in, created at and updated at, which are basically date time fields. Then we're going to define a string representation of our model. We can say define underscore string. So the string representation is going to just return the self.name. Then we are going to define another function, define get school, school underscore first underscore name. So here we're going to return the first name. So you can say return self.name. Then we're going to split it, split it based on the index. So index 0, give me the first one. That's basically it for our model. Then in the school's admin.py file, let's add our models to the Django admin. So here in the admin, add our models. You can say from django.contrib import admin, then from leaflet, we had installed this package, leaflet.admin, we are going to import leaflet geo admin, like that. Then from our models, we're going to import the school model. Then we can create the admin. You can say school admin, subclasses leaflet geo admin. Then for the list display, I want to display some fields from my model. I want to display the name, I want to display the province, I want to display the district. Then let's have the level 2, and then should we have male and female? Whatever, let's just add male and female, like that. Then let's register this in our admin. You can say admin.site.register. We're registering the school model and we're using the school admin class. With that done, let's initialize git and add a .gitignore file. So go back to our terminal. Let's just say npx git ignore, git ignore python. You're only going to be able to use this command if you have Node installed. So if you don't have Node installed, you can just go to your browser, navigate to this site, gitignore, then just type here python, then create, then you automatically copy this and create the file .gitignore and paste it here. It's basically the same thing. So with that, with this done, go back to my terminal and say git init, initialize a git repository. Then let's commit our code, so we can come back to IDE and say this is a chore. Let's say the chore is just set, so set up Django add school model, like that. Boom, that's basically done. The next thing we're going to do is install Django Environ to help with our environment variables and psychobg2 binary for connection to Postgres. So you can go back to our terminal and say pip install Django environ and psychobg2 binary. With those two installs, we can add our packages to our requirement.txt file by saying pip freeze requirements.txt, or you can also add them manually if you want. Then back in our project root, we're going to add a .env environment file and add some environment variables. So here we can just say new file .env for environment variables. Then we're going to add some environment variables for to be used in our Docker Compose file and our school settings.py file. So the first one is going to be postgres_user. I'm just going to say that is the admin. Then postgres_pass. That's going to be admin 1. Let's just say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for now. Then we're going to have Postgres DB. The database is just going to call it school. So remember, some of these environment variables will be used in our Docker Compose, others in our project settings with py file. Then the next one is database. Database is just Postgres. Whoa! Postgres, like that. Then we're going to have pg_host. Postgres host is just going to be, we're going to create a service called Postgres DB. Then the next one, let's just copy this down. We're going to say pg port. The port is going to be 5432. Then the next one is going to be secret key, debug and allowed hosts. So if you just go back to your settings.py file here. So the next one is going to be secret key. So let's just copy all of this, put it here. But remember, in our .env, no spaces, so kill the space between the equal sign. Then the next one is going to be debug. Back in our settings, let's just copy this .env. Let's say debug is going to be true. Then allowed hosts, which is going to be a list, so you can say allowed hosts. So we're going to say we're going to allow localhost, then 127.0.0.1 and any other value. So just say can use slicing. So close that, localhost, that and that. Save this file. Then in the school settings.py file, incorporate some of the environment variables. So we come back to settings.py file here, and we can say at the top we can import, let's do an import. So we can remember we had installed Django environ, right? So we can say import and environ like that. Then we are going to set casting on the default value of debug. So you can say env is equals to environ.env, environ.env. Then we can say debug is going to be boolean. We're going to cast it to boolean and the default is going to be false. Then we are going to say environ.env dot read env. We're going to say use the env file, read from the environment file, env file specified, and the env file is dot env. Then secret key and the debug key. So we can say for secret key here, we're going to load it from environment variables. You can say env and its secret key. We call it secret key. For debug is the same. Let's just copy this, paste it here, and say this is debug. Then for the allowed hosts, it's going to be env. Whoa, you say env. And it's going to be allowed hosts. That's what we had called it. And we're going to split. We're going to split this, not by the comma, by the space. With that done, scroll back to the databases section. Then we are going to change some things here. So for the engines, we're going to change this and say, since it's a JS application, we're going to say the engine is going to be django.contrib.js.db.backends. Whoa, not catalog. .backends.postgis. Then for the name, user, password, and the host, we're going to load this from our environment variables. So let me just bring them in. Like this. So remember this Postgres user, Postgres pass, the host and the port, all these were declared here in our previous environment variables. With all this done, it's time to dockerize. So create a dockerfile.dev in the root directory. Dockerfiles are simply blueprints for creating images. So here you can say new file, let's call this dockerfile.dev. And we're going to have some commands. So the first command we're going to say it's from. So the base image you're going to be using is Python version 3.9. Slimbuster. Then we're going to create a work directory. So our working directory here. Working directory is going to be /app. So our working directory is basically the our final application working directory inside the container when it's finally created from this image. Then the next thing we're going to create is a directory called Postgres data. So you can say run make directory -p /postgres_data. Then we are going to set some environment variables. The first one is Python don't write bytecode, which prevents Python from writing .pyc files to disk. So we can just bring that in. Then the next one is Python unbuffered, which prevents Python from buffering standard out and standard errors. So bring that in. Then we are going to install psychobg2 dependencies. So we are going to run a command. The command is going to be run apt-get update first, then install netcat, GCC, and Postgres. Those are just psychobg2 dependencies. Then we're also going to run a command to update and install some dependencies needed by GDAL. That is the Geographic Data Abstraction Library. So that's it. Then we're going to upgrade our pip version. So we're going to say run pip. Install upgrade pip. Then we're going to copy the requirements to the image. So you can say copy .requirements.txt. Then the destination is /app in our working directory requirements.txt. Then we are going to run another command, that is pip install -r requirements.txt. Then we're going to copy over the project with the copy command. You can say copy over everything in the current directory to /app, like that. With that done, we're going to create a .dockerignore in the project root. So create a new file, call this dockerignore. So dockerignore files allow you to mention a list of files and or directories which you might want to ignore while building the image. So I have a snippet for this. You can just create. So I created a snippet for my dockerignore. So you can just copy this and add it as a snippet to your VS Code to make it easier. Then next, we're going to create a docker-compose.yml file in our project root. This file describes the services that will make up our app during development. In our case, the school API service and the PostGIS database. The compose file also describes which Docker images these services use, how they link together, any volumes they might need, and also which ports these services expose. So just create it. Call it docker-compose.yml. Then here we're going to use the version of the API, which is 3.9. Then we're going to declare our services. So the services. So the first service I'm going to declare is the school API. That's basically our backend API service. So we are going to build this service using our context. And the context is going to be the current directory. And we are going to use a Docker file. The Docker file we're going to use is dockerfile.dev, the Docker file we had defined earlier. Then the container name for this is going to be, let's just call this school-api. That's it. Then we are going to have a command in development. So the command we're going to run in development is Python 3. manage.py run server, and we're going to run on the default port, which is 8000. Then we're going to declare some volumes. So in development we declare a volume, so the volume here is going to be dot into slash app. So here we're basically, volume here mounts the code to the container and updates the container when the change to source code is made. Without this, you'd have to rebuild the image each time changes are made to source code. So this is very useful just in development. Then we're going to declare the ports. So the ports here, we're going to say map ports 8000, the container to 8000 on machine. Then use the environment file. We're going to say use the environment file we had defined above, and the environment file is .env. Because env is in the same level as the Docker Compose file, like that. Then we're going to have a restart policy. We can say restart our API only on failure. Then we're going to say our API service depends on our database, right? The Postgis database. So you can say it depends on another service. We're going to call it PostgresDB. We're yet to create the service, don't worry about this. Then we're going to create some networks. So the networks here is going to be, just call this network school API. Then the next service we're going to create is now the database, the Postgres service. So you can say Postgres DB. So the Postgres DB is going to have an image. So the image is going to be, we're going to get this image from Docker Hub. It's called Kartoza / PostJS. You're using version 12 of Postgres, so use version 12 of that. So you can get this image straight from Docker Hub. We're going to declare some ports. Then the ports we're going to declare is 5432. 5432. Map it to 5432. Then we're going to declare volumes here. And volumes here is for persistent storage. Where do you want to store our data? The container. We're going to store it in Postgres. Data, and we're going to, Postgres automatically stores its data in a particular directory, which is /var/lib/postgresql, like that. So remember, in our Docker file we had created the directory Postgres data. This is only run in some development environments. In other environments you don't necessarily need to run this command, but for safe measure let's just run this command. Then we're going to declare some environment, and the environment here, here's where we're going to declare our environment variables. Remember, we had created the environment variables here: Postgres user, Postgres pass, and Postgres DB. This is the time where we're going to use them. So we're just going to bring them in. So in our Docker Compose file, we can just bring them in. So Postgres user is going to get them from the environment variable of Postgres user, the same to the password from the environment variable, the same from the DB, from the environment variable. This is how you get it from the environment variable with a dollar sign. Then we're going to have a restart policy. Restart policy here is going to for the database. Let's restart this on failure. Then create our networks. We can see the networks here. We're going to use the same network. There'll be the same network. That's a school API network. And that's basically it. Then the last thing we need to do is declare our network. So we've used some networks. So we're going to declare networks. And the network is going to be school API. API like that. And it's going to use the driver, which is the bridge. Then the next thing we need to declare is the volume. So we had said for Postgres database / PostGIS, we're going to store some data in a particular volume. So let's declare our volume here. We're going to call this Postgres data, like that. And that's basically it. So please make sure in your Docker Compose.yml file, there's strict adherence to indentation. Make sure like services in the root level with the networks and volumes, and the other services are indented in. So the school API service and the Postgres database service are on the same level. Then the rest should follow in place. Remember, we have declared some environment variables in our Docker Compose YML file. To see how Docker Compose file content looks after the environment variables have been substituted, we can go back to our terminal and run. Let me just clear this. We can run here Docker Compose config. So this will basically show us how our Docker Compose file will look like after all environment variables have been substituted. So you can see for our Postgres database, the Postgres DB, Postgres password are being substituted from our environment variables. So we set up everything correctly. Then the volumes is okay. Then go back to our school API service. You can see from our environment variables, everything is being loaded. So should there be any mistake, that's how you know. This is the command you can use to confirm if everything is okay. To shorten the Docker commands that we type out in the terminal, we shall use the make utility. The make utility requires a file, which is called a make file, that defines a set of tasks to be executed. Please note that it's not a must to use make files. You can as well type out all Docker commands in the terminal. So back in our server directory, we're going to create a make file. This is completely optional, as I've said before. So in the make file, we're going to have an if statement that just imports our environment variable. Then we're now going to declare our command. So the first command is the build command, the Docker Compose build command. So this, if you say make build, we're going to run Docker Compose app dash dash build and remove any orphans if available. Then the other Docker command we can say is app. So that will be Docker Compose. Compose app. Then the next one will be down. So that is Docker Compose. Compose down. Then the next one is going to be migrate, to run our migrations. So you can say migrate. We're going to say migrate will be Docker Compose execute on the school API service Python 3 manage.py migrate, and there should be no input. Then to make migrations, so let me just copy it. It's Docker command exec on the school API service. Now this is going to be make migrations. Then the next one is going to be super user, to create a super user. So let me just copy this exec Python. The last command is going to be create super user. Then to bring down the containers plus volume, you can say down dash v. We can say this is going to be docker compose down with the volumes. Then the next one is going to be to inspect the volumes in our containers. So it's docker volume inspect. Then we're going to inspect on the schools src folder, and it's the volume was Postgres. We declare the volume as Postgres data. So let me just make this a little bit readable, add some spaces in between the make commands like that. Then like that. So as you can see, you can either choose to run these commands in a terminal every time, but I prefer using makefiles, because now, for example, if I need to make a migration, I don't have to type in the terminal all the time. Docker compose exec the service python 3 manager py blah 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 blah. I just say make migrations. Okay, or I can say make up, make build to build my containers, as you shall see shortly. It makes life a little bit easier. So it's time to put this to the test. To go back to terminal, let me just duplicate this, then clear this. So I can say here in the root directory, I can just say make to build my containers. I can say make build like that. As you can see, it's running the docker compose build remove orphans command. So with our containers built, we can do a migration to add the default Django models to our database. So back in the terminal, we can just say make migrate like that. As you can see, it's running the docker exec command with space before, and our migration is done. Then we can make our school model migration. So if you're asking what migrations are, they're basically Django's way of propagating changes you make to your models, such as adding a field, deleting a field etc into your database schema. So you can say here make migrations. As you can see, the command runs, the migration is created. Then you can remigrate. So we can say make migrate. So we can also confirm that our Postgres slash Postgres volume was declared in our docker compose file was created. So we can just say make volume like that. So if you get this message, it was successfully created, as you can see. Perfect. Lastly, we shall create a super user so that we're able to log into the admin page. So we can say make super user. So our super user will just be called admin. No email, password can just be admin123456. Admin123456. Perfect. So you can go back to our browser. So you can navigate to localhost 8000, and our default Django page should load. Go to slash admin. Let's log in. As you can see, our model is here. Then let's add some schools. So for testing purposes, we're just going to create some fictitious schools. So you can come to the add button. So the school name, the first one is going to be, let's just call this Horizon Education Institute. These are non-existent schools in Rwanda, by the way. I'm just like getting fictitious data. So we can say province, let's say this is in Kigali. The school district, let's just call it District 1. The school level, let's say this is pre-nursery. Number of male students is 23. Female students is 67. There's electricity available. The school code is 1. Then for the school location, let's just Gali somewhere there, Gali City. Then the date is just today and now. And save and add another one. Let's like the next one, let's call this preparatory. The next one, let's just call this preparatory school. This one can be the Eastern Province. School district is just called this District 2. school level can be primary school, number of students can be 1,034, female students can be 286. Oh, but other severe deficiency of female students. Okay, electricity available is yes. We can say this is one. Then the school location, we said it's in the Eastern Province. Okay, this Eastern Province is somewhere there. I hope so. Then today, now, save another. You just want us to have at least four schools or five. The next one can be, let's pick a name, let's call this Highgate School Academy Province. We've done Eastern, let's do Western Province. School District, let's do, this is District 3 now. The school level can be General Secondary. Male students this time can be 12, but the female students can be 345. Let's say that school has no electricity, you can just say 1. And you can have it in the Western Province, somewhere, I hope somewhere there, it's correct. Then today and now, save another. Let's call this one High Impact Institute. Just create that. Then we've done Eastern, Western, let's do Northern. This is District 4. Or let's just say District, District 4. School level is pre-nursery. It has no male students, but it has like 45 female students. School code, this one can be 5. No, let's just make this 4. Then add the location using the map. It's in the north. Let's just say that's the, let's assume that's the north. Then just say today and now. Save and add another, so we can do one for the south. So let's just call this one Mentoring the Future as a school. Southern Province, District 5. School level can be a TVET. Male students is 176. Female students can be 238. There's electricity. Let's call this 5. Give it a 5. Then school location is in the south. Let's assume south is somewhere there. Boom, done. So if you save, we have at least our dummy schools done. As you can see, the list display works. If you click on one of them, the location pops up on the leaflet map that we had configured before. So this basically means our application as at now works perfectly. So you can go back to our terminal and let's commit our code. So we can say this is a chore. Set up Docker and post JS. Then make that commit. So that basically marks the end of part 1 of this series. In part 2, we shall set up Nginx, then serialize and create our Django API endpoints. Thereafter, in part 3, we are going to now go to the frontend and display our map using React, Leaflet, Bootstrap, Nginx, amongst others. Cheers!